Getting better Wi-Fi has been a constant struggle. As I've added more and more Wi-Fi devices to my home over the years, the network can get more crowded. Plus, you can have dead zones or issues with speed. Sometimes Wi-Fi can just be a huge hassle. So I'm going to walk you through what I did to get better Wi-Fi performance. I'll take you through some of the latest tech in Wi-Fi that you can put in your home today, and I'll explain why I let NETGEAR sponsor this video. Now, the first approach I took several years ago to get better Wi-Fi performance in my home was by going with a mesh Wi-Fi networking solution. In the early days of Wi-Fi, most of us just bought a single Wi-Fi router which connected to a modem. The closer you are to the router, the better your speeds and connection. And this approach often leaves part of your home either with weak signal or no Wi-Fi signal at all. And this is where mesh Wi-Fi networks come into play, and this is my first recommendation when trying to solve Wi-Fi coverage issues. Mesh networks are made up of multiple router devices. Typically, you have a main router that plugs into a modem and then additional Wi-Fi points, otherwise known as satellite routers, that will connect to the main router and create a seamless single Wi-Fi network for your entire home and avoid many of the disadvantages of Wi-Fi extenders like separate network names, decreased speeds, issues with Wi-Fi network compatibility, and issues with configuration and management. Sometimes the hardware for the main router and then the satellites or Wi-Fi points is actually slightly different, like with my current Orbi Wi-Fi 6E mesh system. Or there's no difference in hardware between the device you designate as the main router and satellites, like with the Google Wi-Fi system. Typically, the larger your home is, the more additional Wi-Fi points you'll need. Most of the time, routers and Wi-Fi points will be rated for a certain amount of coverage, which will help you figure out how many you'll need in your setup. And because you can add multiple Wi-Fi points to your home, this is often going to help you eliminate dead zones in Wi-Fi coverage. And by going with a mesh networking solution, you will often also find that you'll get more consistent speeds throughout your home. There are several popular models out there on the market today, like the NETGEAR Orbi Wi-Fi 6 or 6E mesh system. I'm using the 6E system currently, but previously I used the Wi-Fi 6 version. The Google Wi-Fi routers, Nest Wi-Fi routers, Eero mesh routers, TP-Link Deco, and others. And to see our long-term reviews of these and upcoming Wi-Fi routers, make sure you're subscribed to the channel. Now lately, there have been a few advancements in Wi-Fi technology that you may have heard of, like Triband technology, Wi-Fi 6, and Wi-Fi 6E. Triband technology is a development specifically for mesh Wi-Fi networks to help improve their stability and speed. Routers use frequency bands for your devices to connect to them. Now, on most routers in existence today, there are two frequency bands that you'll see, 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz, though there is now a third band, and we'll talk about that in just a second. But those two bands explained why sometimes when you're on your phone and you bring up a Wi-Fi network list, you'll see a Wi-Fi network listed twice, only one of the names will be like Wi-Fi network name and then like 5 gigahertz. That's why you're seeing that. And in general, if you care about Wi-Fi speeds, you should always connect to the 5 gigahertz network unless the signal strength is just really poor. 5 gigahertz is typically faster but has a shorter range, where the 2.4 gigahertz network band has a longer range. Now, how is Triband different? Well, as the name suggests, each router actually has three bands, a 5 gigahertz band, a 2.4 gigahertz band, and then an additional 5 gigahertz band that is dedicated for moving internet traffic back and forth between your main router and Wi-Fi points, which makes speeds more consistent and reliable around your home. Now, the next Wi-Fi technology that can make a huge difference in your home is Wi-Fi 6. It's one of the latest Wi-Fi standards and is otherwise known as the IEEE 802.11AX standard. Rolls right off the tongue, doesn't it? Now, like previous Wi-Fi standards, Wi-Fi 6 also includes the 2.4 and 5 gigahertz bands. So then what exactly is the difference with Wi-Fi 6, you may ask? Three things. The first big difference with Wi-Fi 6 is it can handle many more Wi-Fi devices on the network simultaneously versus previous standards. So if you're like me and you have a ton of Wi-Fi enabled devices, especially for things like smart home products, this feature is very beneficial. The second advantage of Wi-Fi 6 is it can actually help improve the battery life of your devices. The Wi-Fi 6 standard allows devices to plan out communications with your router ahead of time, which reduces the time your devices need to keep their antennas powered on to transmit and search for signals, thus reducing their power consumption and improving their battery life. And if you want to learn more about this standard, The Verge has a great guide to Wi-Fi 6 that I'll link in the description below. The third advantage of Wi-Fi 6 is something called WPA3 security, and what this security standard does is it makes it harder for hackers to crack passwords by just constantly guessing them. So that's everything that Wi-Fi 6 brought to the Wi-Fi standard. So then what exactly is Wi-Fi 6E? And this leads me to NETGEAR and their new Orbi Wi-Fi 6E mesh system. Now, I let NETGEAR sponsor this video because out of all of the routers I have personally tested, their Orbi Wi-Fi 6 mesh system has been the best I have tested. I've used that system now for 6 months plus, and it's been the best in terms of its overall range, its ability to handle a ton of devices on the network simultaneously, and it's given me the most consistent speeds out of any Wi-Fi networking system I have used thus far. So when I saw NETGEAR was the first company to put out a Wi-Fi 6E enabled router, and soon after they released an Orbi Wi-Fi 6E mesh system, I asked NETGEAR to send me one and if they wanted to sponsor this video, which they agreed, since I thought their new mesh system would be the perfect system to use to help illustrate the difference Wi-Fi 6E can make. The new Orbi Wi-Fi 6E mesh system has a new 6 GHz Wi-Fi band, which is reserved exclusively for 6E devices. This is the main difference with Wi-Fi 6E. For devices that support connecting through the 6 GHz band, you're going to see much faster Wi-Fi speeds. You can stream at speeds of up to 10.8 gigabits per second and have up to 200 concurrent devices on the network at one time. And it's been designed to be able to handle up to 16 simultaneous Wi-Fi video streams in your home, so you shouldn't run into any issues streaming video with this Wi-Fi system. The 6 GHz band also helps increase network capacity because the newer devices that you add to your network will move to the 6 GHz band while you're legacy devices will stay on the 2.4 and 5 GHz bands. By going with this router system over the Wi-Fi 6 version, you're basically just future-proofing your setup. Now, another interesting thing that NETGEAR did with their Orbi Wi-Fi 6E mesh system is they used quad band technology. So your devices can access a 2.4, 5, and 6 GHz band, while the routers reserve a dedicated additional 5 GHz backhaul connection for passing data between the router and satellites wirelessly, just like the Orbi Wi-Fi 6 mesh system does. And the system also comes with a dedicated IoT Wi-Fi network for all of your smart home devices. The NETGEAR Orbi Wi-Fi 6E mesh system delivers up to 9,000 square feet of coverage with just one router and two satellites, which is kind of insane. And each additional satellite you add to your setup will get you an additional 3,000 square feet of coverage. So if you want to learn more about the latest Orbi Wi-Fi 6E mesh system, click the link in the description below. So that's everything with Wi-Fi 6E, but there are a few more tips I want to cover before we wrap this video on how to overall improve your Wi-Fi performance at home, and some of these don't even involve buying anything new. The first is placement of your routers. Whether you have existing mesh routers or you're planning to buy new ones, you'll want to make sure that you space them out correctly, as this can impact the performance of your system. Most of these routers nowadays come with apps that include a network signal strength tool that can help tell you if your router placement is correct or not. Another thing that'll help you with your overall Wi-Fi network performance is to make sure your Wi-Fi points are within line of sight of each other if possible. Hiding Wi-Fi routers in cabinets or behind pieces of furniture or behind a TV, those situations can all limit your Wi-Fi performance, which is why most modern Wi-Fi routers are designed with a better aesthetic to help them more easily blend in with your home decor. Now, another thing I recommend to getting better Wi-Fi performance in your home is to, of course, buy your own Wi-Fi router or mesh networking system and not just use the one that your ISP, which stands for Internet Service Provider, don't just use the one that they gave you. Now, sometimes your Internet Service Provider will give you a combination Wi-Fi router and modem device. And if they don't charge you a monthly rental fee or anything for it, it's okay to keep that device acting like a modem, but I would still personally buy my own Wi-Fi router, especially a mesh system, because you're just gonna get better performance and likely a router that supports the latest Wi-Fi standards compared to what your ISP gave you. And if you buy your own mesh system, make sure if you have a modem that is a combination modem and router from your internet service provider, you figure out a way to disable the Wi-Fi radios on that device. Otherwise, the Wi-Fi that's outputting from the device your ISP gave you will likely interfere with the router that you just bought. So if you're looking to future-proof your setup a bit, take a look at NETGEAR's new Orbi Wi-Fi 6E mesh system by clicking on the link in the description below. And make sure you're subscribed to the channel to see our 6 months later review of this new system. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you have any further questions about how to get better Wi-Fi performance, leave them in a comment below and I'll answer them there. And while you're down there, make sure you hit that thumbs up button if you found this video helpful, and subscribe to the channel for more reviews on Wi-Fi routers and Wi-Fi mesh networking systems. And if you're looking for what to watch next, check out some of our long-term reviews of Wi-Fi routers, which you can get to by clicking on the playlist to the right. For 6 months later, I'm Josh Tedder. Thanks for watching.